Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Make MBBS Easy. This video is about a quick overview on pneumococcus. It is a diplococci as you can see in the picture. Pneumococci is also known as Streptococcus pneumoniae. Now come to the morphology of this bacteria. It is gram-positive diplococci which is non-motile, non-sporing and capsulated. The culture is done only in enriched media with blood, egg or serum, as in blood agar or chocolate agar. It can also be cultured in liquid media in which it produces uniform turbidity. In blood agar, it produces alpha hemolysis in aerobic condition and beta hemolysis in anaerobic condition because it produces oxygen labile hemolysin. In prolonged incubation in blood agar, it produces carom coin appearance or Drossman colony due to central ambonation formed by radially autolysis of the bacteria in the central zone, which gives a concentric ring appearance when seen from above. So it's called carom coin appearance colony. In chocolate agar, it produces greenish discoloration. The colony morphology is flat, raised edges, central ambonation due to radially autolysis of this bacteria in the central portion mainly, as I mentioned above. Now come to important biological tests. It is catalase negative, which help to differentiate it from staphylococcus species. It is oxidase negative, which help to differentiate it from gram negative diplococci nigeria. It is bile soluble, which help to differentiate it from streptococcus pyogenes and streptococcus virulens. And it is obtusin susceptible, which again help to differentiate it from Streptococcus viridans. And it insulin fermentation is positive when it is cultured in yeast serum water, which help to differentiate it from Streptococcus viridans. Now come to the antigenic structures of pneumococci. The first is capsular polysaccharide antigen. It is type specific and also known as soluble specific substance. Then next is specific cell wall carbohydrate, and the innermost is somatic M protein. Now come to the toxins. As I told above, the oxygen labile hemolysin is produced by pneumococci, and another toxin is leukocidin. Now come to the main section, that is pathogenesis. The main pathogenesis produced by pneumococci is pneumonia. There may be lobar pneumonia in the lung, may be bronchopneumonia. It's also responsible for meningitis at any age. The other pathogenesis are emphysema, pericarditis, otitis media infection, sinusitis, suppurative arthritis, conjunctivitis and peritonitis as well. Lab diagnosis of pneumococci. The specimen is sputum, CSF or blood according to the site of infection. And collection and transport is done at 37 degrees Celsius because the other organism caused the new meningitis is Haemophilus influenzae, which may die at lower temperature. So the collection and transport is done at 37 degrees Celsius. Then direct microscopy is revealed gram-positive diplococci. Capsular swelling may be seen in type-specific antisera mixed with the specimen due to capsular antigen antibody reactions. And then the specimen is cultured in blood agar, and the typical colony morphology is seen for pneumococci. And then the colony is stained and viewed under microscope, so the results of a gram positive diplococci and the specific types of that is capsular swelling and capsular antigen antibody reaction is also seen in the from this culture. And the biochemical reaction, as I mentioned above, bile salt solubility test is positive, insulin fermentation is positive, obtusin sensitivity is the pneumococcus is obtusin susceptible, and oxidase negative and catalase negative as well. And the last is animal pathogenicity test in mice by intraperitoneal inoculation of the bacteria taken from the culture, and the mice die due to infection, and the peritoneal exudate as well as cardiac fluid will reveal the bacteria, pneumococci, and the antibiotic sensitivity test is required if the bacteria form resistivity to any specific antibiotic drug. Now come to the treatment. The treatment is done with the very common antibiotics, that is penicillin, cephalosporin. As common antibiotics do not show such resistance towards the bacteria, it's rare to them that the bacteria strain will resistant to common antibiotics like penicillin, cephalosporin. And now the last section is prophylaxis. It is done with the three types of vaccines, that is PPSV for 23 strains, polysaccharide vaccines, and the second is PCV7, that is pneumococcal conjugate vaccine, for 7 serotypes, and PCV13, that is pneumococcal conjugate vaccine, for 13 strains. Here the pneumococcal conjugate vaccine 7 is added with the 6 more strains, so it is 6 more serotypes. So the vaccine is now available is PCV13, which is applicable for young children also. Thanks for watching. If you have any queries, leave a comment in comment section. Have a nice day.